Yes, let us take the next paragraph. We are dealing here in the realm of the imponderable and encounter problems beyond the reach of mass analysis, a realm where we can only observe effects alone. Yes, here, what do you mean by imponderable? Imponderable, which are existed, but we can't measure it. For example, what is the example of this imponderable? That is a radioactive element, or moonlight. Yes, we observe this moonlight, but you can't measure whatever the effect responsible on human being, isn't it? And therefore, there is a sometime in the psychiatric cases, some symptom or mental symptoms are aggravated in new moon or in full moon, or the mental symptoms are also developed according to the phases of moon. And therefore, we are dealing here the realm of the imponderable. That is mean it is a very imponderable. That is a we can observe the effect only and encounter problem beyond the reach of the man's analysis, but we can't explain what effect actually occurred on the human mind or on the human body. The realm where we can only observe effect only. Yes, we only observe the effect while we are totally unable to analyze on the physical ground or any explanation given of this effect on the chemical ground also. However, we all can see and all we can hope to know in our observation of human beings is the effect of growth and development. And it is so with our study of medical action. Yes, we see the we all can see and all we can hope to know our observation of human being is the effect of growth and development. And it is so with the our study of medical action. Yes, it is how this it is very fine and very subtle actions are going on, and similarly this action of the medicine is occurred, or whenever we consume food, the nutrients are absorbed, and very subtle level, or you can't explain how this growth and development of the human being occur. It is very complicated and very, you can say, unexplainable methods occur in the human body. Similarly, the action of the drug is also act at the same level. You can't explain it. This is so not only in the study of the potency, but it is so almost entirely in the study of the crude drugs and their action, as well as our study of foods and their action. The effects are there is there to be seen, but the imponderable nature of the modus operandi is beyond our comprehension. Yes, in somewhat level you can explain the how the action or whatever is the modus operandi of these drug substances or any food material, while you totally unable to explain the effect of this imponderable things, how these act or what is the modus operandi of this imponderable sources on our body. It is beyond our comprehension. Yes, we can't analyze it, we can't study it, we can't explain it. The best example is a moonlight, and the how this affect this moonlight on them, or how it is responsible for the changes the mood of the or mood swings of the psychiatric patient. The very same line of evidence is produced in all these fields. It is the effect only that are manifest to us. the observations must be recorded, and only by deduction can we comprehend their innermost meaning. Yes, we can only observe the effect and we note down it, and from the deduction method we concluded that this or what happened or something is happened because of this, and we only put out the conclusion from this thing. Many mistakes have been made by failing to follow rules laid by Hahnemann in his Organon of Healing Art. Follow these rules and the results will be in order and observable. Yes, H. Robert told that so many mistakes are there while we apply or whatever is the rules principle laid down by Hahnemann in his Organon of Healing Art. If we follow this rule very strictly, then you can observe the very desirable effect of this homeopathic medicine. Many of the graduates from homeopathic colleges do not grasp the dynamic concept of drugs, and for that reason always stay in the material plane, using only the crude drug or venturing into the low potencies occasionally. That means these in medical college also they are totally devoid of this experience taken by this potentized drug. They only believe on the material dose of the medicine. They only observe they only desire to cure the tissue changes or the which are the ultimates of the disease, and therefore their viewpoint is very much material, isn't it? And therefore they use the low potencies, while in the crude drugs are also used. This is unfortunate for the efficacy of their work. For once this concept is grasped, they realize that all potencies are valuable and useful, and they soon obtain a knowledge and power over disease little realized when viewed solely from the material plane. Yes, each and every potency has its own importance, and you know, according to the susceptibility, according to the nature of the disease, according to the pathological changes whatever develop in that particular disease, you have a full freedom to select the suitable potency for the particular patient, isn't it? And take the result according to the rule. Whenever we select the proper potency in a proper condition or for the proper condition, you definitely have a result of that potency. And not only you realize on you should not only concentrate on the material plane of the disease, that is a pathological changes. Especially in this is this true in chronic troubles, for the taste of real skill is in the cure of chronic patient and the eradication of the chronic miasm. Yes, this chronic troubles means this, because of this chronic disease, the so many pathological changes are developed, very tenacious diseases develop, and it is skill to apply this varied potency in the chronic condition and for the eradication of the chronic miasm. The use of the attenuated potency varies with each individual because of his interpretation of the law of dose. Hahnemann's question is to how for the dose of a homeopathic remedy in any given case of disease ought to be reduced in order to derive from it the best possible cure is one we may well ask. Yes, the use of the attenuated potency, that means a highly potentized medicine, higher potency, these are varies with each individual. Yes, it you have to select various or you have a scope to select various other ranges range from the potency which is exactly suitable to that particular case. And because of his interpretation of the law of dosages by the according to the law of posology, you have to select the definite potency and the repetition of the dose. Hahnemann's question is to how for the dose of a homeopathic remedy in any given case of disease ought to be reduced in order to derive from the best possible cure. Yes, Hahnemann desired that, or Hahnemann asked you question that you have to select very or you have to administer very minimum quantity of the medicine and very minimum dose in order to cure the disease. And therefore, what will be the minimum dose of the particular patient is differ from person to person. But our aim is to, according to the law of dose, you have to select the suitable potency in a particular case. It may be readily convinced that no theoretical conjecture will furnish an answer to this problem, and it is not by such means that we can establish in respect to each individual medicine the quantity of the dose that suffix to produce the homeopathic effect and accomplish a prompt and gentle cure. No reasoning, however ingenious, will avail in this instance. It is by pure experiment and precise observation only that is this object can be obtained. Yes, in you know, there is no fixed law or there is no a fixed indication to give such and such potency. म्हणजे 30th potency द्या, 200th potency द्या, 1 mm द्यायला पाहिजे असं काहीही नाही. एव्हरी टाइम एव्हरी केस इज न्यू फॉर अस. अँड बाय असेसिंग द ससेप्टेबिलिटी ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पेशंट, बाय असेसिंग द नेचर ऑफ द पर्टिक्युलर डिसीज, by assessing the pathological changes, whether it is reversible or irreversible, and whatever is the miasm manifested in that particular case and the condition of the patient, as well as the susceptibility and the nature of the vital force, everything you have to consider at a time, and in toto you have to select a proper potency which is exactly suitable to that particular patient. It is a homeopathy dose, isn't it? And therefore it is not very a fixed indication. It is changeable according to the or in respect to each individual patient as well as each individual medicine. For example, you know there are acute remedies are there and chronic remedies are there. Acute remedy, according to this name itself, indicate the acute remedy which are very rapid action, and because of this rapidity you select this remedy for the acute condition, and therefore these are called as acute remedies. Just like for aconite, belladonna, while some medicine consider as a deep acting medicine, and this deep acting medicine very useful in chronic cases. And therefore the quantity of the dose that suffix to produce the homeopathic effect and accomplish a prompt and gentle cure, therefore you have to select the acute remedies in acute condition and chronic medicine in chronic condition. It is totally depending on the case of the particular patient and how much quantity of the medicine is sufficed to produce the or to effect the gentle cure. No reasoning, however ingenious, will avail in this instance. It is by pure experiment and precise observation. Yes, your experimentation, or whenever you take the, there is no fixed rule for the prescription or for the selection of remedy. It is totally depending on the individual case or how the patient present to you. And therefore you with this application or continuous experimentation or experience, now you have a very precise observation only this that this object can be obtained, then you can overcome this problem with the various other experimentation. Let us take the example, or let us take the explanation which is given in Organon aphorism number 278. Here the question arises as to the proper degree of reduction at which a medicine will procure certain as well as a gentle relief. That is to say, how small must be the dose of each homeopathically selected medicine in order to fulfill the requirement of a perfect cure? Yes, the it is related to the smallness of the doses. जास्तीत जास्त किती कमीत कमी मेडिसिन आपल्याला वापरता येईल याबद्दल हॅनिमन इथे सांगितलेलं आहे. हियर द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस एज टू द प्रॉपर डिग्री ऑफ रिडक्शन ऍट विच अ मेडिसिन इज प्रोक्युअर सर्टन एज वेल एज अ जेंटल रिलीफ. म्हणजे कुठली पोटेन्सी आपण वापरायची आहे जास्तीत जास्त की त्याच्यामुळे जेंटल क्युअर पण मिळेल आणि डेफिनेट क्युअर पण मिळेल. That is to say, how small must be the dose of each homeopathically selected medicine in order to fulfill the requirement of the perfect cure? That means you have to select the suitable dose. To determine the dose of each particular medicine for this purpose and how to render this dose so small as to accomplish its purpose gently and rapidly at the same time. It is a problem which obviously is neither to be solved by theoretical conjecture nor by sophistic reasoning. Yes, the potency selection is very, you can say very, you can say great problem or a problem for the newcomer. But whenever by this clinical experience, by this experience, whenever he observes certain result of the certain potency, then he becomes perfect, isn't it? And therefore this determination of the dose of a particular medicine which is responsible for a particular case, which act rapidly as well as gently. It is not the problem solved by theoretical conjecture. It is not a problem by the theoretically you indicated or you make some rule for the selection of remedy, while or not by the sophistic reasoning or with any new rules, new reasoning. But it is totally depending on the present case. Pure experiments and accurate observation alone can solve the question, and it were folly to adduce the large doses of the old school, destitute of homeopathic bearing upon the diseased portion of the body and affecting only the sound parts, to disprove the result of actual experience in regard to the minuteness of doses requisite to perform a homeopathic cure. Yes, this selection of the potency, this knowledge you can obtain only from the pure experiment. The pure experiment and accurate observation alone can solve the question, and it were folly to adduce the large doses of old school. Yes, it is unnecessary or it is a foolishness to use the crude medicine or the large doses, means large quantity of medicine, the material dose, like the old school, while destitute of the homeopathic bearing upon the diseased portion of the body and affecting only the sound parts. Yes, what happened? Whenever we use the material quantity of the dose, it very apparently act on the diseased part, or along with the diseased part, it affect the sound part of the body. Therefore, you should avoid this crude material medicine. Yes, to disprove the result of the actual experience in regard to the minuteness of this doses requisite to perform the homeopathic cure. Yes, by the experience and by the repeated observation, accurate observation, you only take the experience of the minuteness of the doses which is required to obtain a homeopathic cure, that is a rapid, gentle and permanent cure. Subsequently, the aphorism number is 279. Experience proves that the dose of a homeopathically selected remedy cannot be reduced so far as to be inferior in strength to the natural disease, and to lose its power of extinguishing and curing at least a portion of the same, provided that this dose immediately after having been taken is capable of confusing a slight intensification of symptoms of similar natural disease, that is a slight homeopathic aggravation, which Hahnemann explained in aphorism number 157 to 160. Yes, in this aphorism 279, Hahnemann explained the smallness of the dose. म्हणजे स्मॉलनेस किंवा मायन्यूट डोस द्यायचा, मिनिमम डोस द्यायचा, तो द्यायचा तर किती द्यायचा, तो इतका पण कमी नाही द्यायचा की तो नॅचरल डिसीजला ओव्हरकम करू शकणार नाही. जर त्याने नॅचरल डिसीजला ओव्हरकम केलं नाही, तो जर नॅचरल डिसीज पेक्षा हायर स्ट्रेंथ मध्ये नसेल, स्ट्रॉंगर नसेल, तर तो नॅचरल डिसीज ऑब्व्हियसली एक्सटिंग्विश करू शकणार नाही. आणि म्हणून काय म्हटलेलं आहे बघा, एक्सपिरियन्स प्रूव्स दॅट द डोज ऑफ अ होमिओपॅथिकली सिलेक्टेड, होमिओपॅथिकली दॅट मीन्स नॉट ओनली द सिम्पटम सिमिलॅरिटी बट द पोटेन्शियल सो द प्रॉपर पोटेन्शियल सो सिलेक्टेड, द सिलेक्टेड रेमेडी कॅनॉट बी रिड्यूस सो फार as to be inferior in the strength to the natural disease. म्हणजे जी पोटेन्सी आपण केलेली आहे, आपण रिपिटेशन ऑफ द डोजेस आणखी पोटेन्सी सिलेक्शन, म्हणून इतका पण कमी डिसीज तुम्ही कमी मेडिसिन देऊ नका की जो नॅचरल डिसीजच्या स्ट्रेंथ पेक्षा कमी आर्टिफिशियल डिसीज प्रोड्यूस करेल. अँड इट लॉस इट्स पॉवर ऑफ एक्सटिंग्विशिंग अँड क्युरिंग ऍट लीस्ट पोर्शन ऑफ द सेम, की त्याच्यामध्ये ती क्षमताच राहणार नाही की तो नॅचरल डिसीजला एक्सटिंग्विश करू शकेल, क्युअर करू शकेल. प्रोव्हाइडेड दॅट दिस डोज इमिजिएटली आफ्टर हॅविंग बीन टेकन इज कॅपेबल ऑफ कॉजिंग अ स्लाइट इंटेन्सिफिकेशन ऑफ सिम्पटम. व्हाईल व्हॉट शुड बी द एक्सपेक्टिंग रिझल्ट इज देअर, रिझल्ट वुड बी द देर इज अ स्लाइट इंटेन्सिफिकेशन ऑफ द डिसीज. म्हणजे होमिओपॅथिक मेडिसिन ऍडमिनिस्टर केल्यानंतर आपल्याला काय अपेक्षित आहे की जे कुठले एक्झिस्टिंग सिम्पटम आहेत त्यांचं स्लाइट इंटेन्सिफिकेशन व्हायला पाहिजे, म्हणजे ते थोडे ऍग्रेव्हेट व्हायला पाहिजे. दॅट मीन्स अ स्लाइट इंटेन्सिफिकेशन ऑफ द एक्झिस्टिंग सिम्पटम, दॅट मीन्स द होमिओपॅथिक ऍग्रेव्हेशन. अँड व्हॉट इज द इंडिकेशन ऑफ द होमिओपॅथिक ऍग्रेव्हेशन? इट इज नथिंग बट द although there is a aggravation, patient feels better. Okay.